Hello students, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jagdeep and in this video series we are talking about advanced indifference curve analysis. In our previous video, we talked about price effect where we studied how changes in price of one commodity would lead to changes in the consumption of that particular commodity by the consumer. In this particular video, we shall look at PCC or price consumption curve. Students, if you are coming here on this video for the first time, you need to have a look at the previous videos because what I'm going to talk in this video would not make sense to you if you are not aware about the indifference curve analysis, budget line, you're not aware about consumer equilibrium. So please watch those videos. You shall find the links in my description box. Okay, so without wasting any time further, let's get started. So as I said, we'll be talking about price consumption curve in this particular video. Now, what is a price consumption curve? PCC for short, it is a graphical representation that would show how a consumer's consumption of a particular good would change when the price of that particular good changes. Ceteris paribus, that means all other factors that impact the demand of this commodity are held constant. All right. So whenever the price of the commodity becomes higher, the consumption of that particular commodity might fall, or if the prices fall, the consumption of that commodity might go up. Now, when we talk about a curve, it is supposed to have a slope. So when we talk about PCC, it has three different types of slopes. The first slope is a downward sloping curve, which is generally observed in the case of normal goods. The second type of slope is an upward slope, and it is generally observed in the case of an inferior good. A backward slope is generally observed under given goods. Now, I would not delve into the meaning of these type of goods. You could check out my Instagram reel. You will find videos with the meanings of these terms and examples along with it. Okay, let's take a look at downward sloping PCC curve, and it is supposed to be for normal goods in this particular video. Now, before we move on to the complete analysis, let's talk about real income first. What is real income? As I've written here, real income basically means the purchasing ability of a consumer, and it varies with the price. All right. So when the price of a given commodity falls or increases, it impacts the purchasing ability of a consumer and hence the real income. In simple terms, real income is basically the number of units of a commodity that a consumer could afford to buy with his given income. All right. So let us take a look. I've written a small rule here which says when the price of a commodity rises, purchasing ability would fall. And when the price of a commodity falls, his purchasing ability would rise. Let us say a consumer has a money income of, let's say, $100, and he is spending it on chocolates, which is costing, let us say, $5. So within this $100, a consumer will be able to buy 20 chocolates. That's a given common sense, right? Now, if the price of these chocolates go up to $10, right? So the price has gone up from $5 to $10. Given the money income, which is $100 in this case, a consumer will now be able to buy only 10 chocolates. Isn't this proving this particular segment? How? When the price went up, purchasing ability went down, and consumer is now capable of buying just 10 chocolates as against 20, which he was able to afford earlier, right? So we need to remember that purchasing ability is something we call as our real income, and it moves in the opposite direction of price changes. All right, let's supplement another example for it. Let's say you walk into a store and you look for t-shirts. What are you buying? You're buying a t-shirt, and you think that the t-shirt may cost $100. But the moment you enter the market, you see that there's a discount offered on the t-shirt. Let us say it is a 20% discount. That means you would get the t-shirt now in just 80 bucks and you're left with 20 bucks to spare. So now this 100 bucks that you came in with in the store, thinking that you could buy just one t-shirt, would now help you to buy maybe something else that you could afford in this $20. So you'd be able to buy two units of goods, one t-shirt and one something else. So your real income just went up because there was a discount. I hope this is making the example more clearer. Let us move on to the main example for this particular segment, which is normal goods. Let us talk about money income in this particular example. Money income is equal to $40 and consumer is spending it equally, which is $20 each. All right. Now, this is an assumption that we've made that consumer prefers pizza over chocolate. He's completely disregarding healthy choices. Anyways, chocolate is also not a very healthy choice, but pizza definitely isn't. And the price of pizza slices has just gone down. Now, if we've studied the price effect video and the rotations in budget line, we should be aware that whenever the price of a given commodity falls, a consumer will see a rotation in his budget line. How will the rotation look like? Somewhat like this. Let us say this is the new budget line, which is AB1. Now, price of pizza slices has gone down. That means consumer will increase the quantity of pizza slices. And since he's not really fond of chocolates, he wouldn't mind reducing his consumption of chocolates, right? That means a consumer may be at equilibrium somewhere around here. Let us say this is IC1 and this is equilibrium 1, and probably this is the quantity of pizza slices 1, okay? And this is the quantity of chocolates. So we can see that he's reduced his quantity of chocolates and increased his quantity of pizza slices. Why? Because pizza slices were comparatively cheaper and he preferred pizza over chocolates. Now, if there is a further reduction in the price of pizza slices, what will happen? So if price of pizza slices falls further, consumer will still buy more of pizza slice than what he was, and he would still bring down his consumption of chocolates. Just like we had a rotation in the budget line from B to B1, we will again have a rotation which is outwards on the x-axis. Let us say this is the new budget line, AB2. And since consumer is bringing down his consumption of chocolates, he would not be around this level, anything below this, right? Let us say now the consumer is at equilibrium somewhere here. This is indifference curve 2. Equilibrium 2, this is the new quantity for pizza slices, so pizza slices quantity 2, and quantity of chocolates 2. I did not write 1 over here, so 1. Now again, here consumer has reduced his consumption of chocolates because he does not prefer chocolates, and he's increased his consumption of pizza slices from quantity 1, which is this, to quantity 2, which is this. Now, if you join all these equilibrium points, I'm highlighting it with a different color, you would get something like this. So this is your PCC curve, or a price consumption curve. Now, in this case, a price consumption curve is downward sloping. Why is it downward sloping? Because pizza slices is a normal good. So we need to remember, under normal goods, the price consumption curve would be a downward sloping curve. All right, students, If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. And as I've been telling throughout the video series, the moment I finish this series, I will release notes and quizzes on my Facebook page. So do go and follow my Facebook page as well. The link is in the description box below. I'll see you in another video. Until then, take care. Bye now.